Amici di Nuovo.it, siamo da ICMA 2023 con in mano due scatolette che potrebbero sembrarvi scatolette normali, in realtà sono dei radar. Questa è l'attuale tecnologia radar che Bosch, all'interno del cui stand siamo qui da ICMA 2023, che Bosch fa adottare, insomma, le case che adottano la propria tecnologia. E questa, molto più compatta, lo vedete, è quella che vedremo nel 2025. C'è una grande evoluzione che sta dietro questi dispositivi di sicurezza di cui Bosch da diversi anni, da molti anni in realtà, è leader. Siamo con Mr. Ildrim, Regional President, presidente della divisione due ruote per l'Europa. Thank you, Mr. Ildrim.
Nice to meet you.
Really big evolution between now and then, 2025. But now it's 10 years of motorcycle stability control of Bosch. Do you feel like you are pioneers, visionaries, or something like that?
Yes, yes, of course, because, you know, we all are motorcyclists. So we like motorcycle riding. And therefore, we developed the motorcycle or this MSC system for ourselves.
Yep.
But the basic idea behind is safety for all motorcycles, for all segments. And that's the basic idea. That's the reason why we say MSC is a system that can be applied for different bikes and different bike segments. And as we have started MSC, the system level was, what can we do on the bike? So, MSC is a reactive system. What does it mean? I have some sensors, like the IMU, for measuring the lean angle. I have some wheel speed sensors. And when the criticality is coming, system reacts.
Okay.
So, and then we made it lean angle dependent. This was a big step forward for braking and acceleration. And after we have then brought this MSC now for all different segments, the logical next step was then not only to see what's happening on the bike. Next step is what's happening around the bike.
Bluetooth and something like that.
Exactly. Maybe. Then we have seen, okay, which technology would help us. So we tested different sensor concepts and we found out that radar is very stable. Why? Because, you know, radar is not that much influenced from the weather conditions, from light, from different things, or from the lean angle. So therefore we said the right direction is the radar, and we put it on the bike, tested, modified and developed algorithm, and this was the since end of 2020 the first generation is on the market and in usage, and now we are already working on the next generation, which is this one, which will come 2025 into the field.
You can tell me which bike will fit it.
I can't tell you.
You can. Okay.
This is the task of the OEM, so
we're
supporting OEMs and but of course, you may know all these guys.
Okay, now I understand, yes. Let's talk about democracy of technology.
Yeah.
These devices are for big bikes, big displacement bikes, premium bikes.
Yes.
But what about the bikes of small displacement? And will they be safer in the future?
Honestly, our slogan is MSC for all. And this year, the TVS bike with the 300cc will come with the MSC system in India. I mean, isn't that great? Because we have now the system which we come with the high end, coming now to the smaller bikes, modified to their needs, modified to their function set. And therefore, we are bringing technology not only for the big bikes, consequently, we are bringing the technology step by step also to the different segments and different areas, because we think the systems are very valuable in terms of safety and comfort, and therefore we have a worldwide organization who supports not only the big bikes in Europe, Japan or USA. We are also present in India, China, Asia, and
very huge markets anyway. Very huge markets. Let's talk about the evolution. What would come in the future? Because some years ago, when a radar appeared into the market, we say, "Oh, it's a really great solution."
Yeah.
But everybody was looking for V2X.
Yes.
The way the old vehicles and surroundings communicate between us. But it seems that now that technology has come to a sudden stop. Is it?
No, technology never stops.
Ah, okay.
Why? Because with bringing the technology, we gain more and more information from the market, from what's happening. So As I told you, the first step was reactive systems on the bike. We have ABS, MSC.
Yep.
The next step is integrating what's happening around the bike. This is ARAS. So this is this radar system. The next logical step is to connect the bikes to the cloud. And then once you do this, you have then opened the space for new functions, like software update over the air, like function and demand, like yesterday our president told. So connectivity-based functions are then the next step where we will bring more and more functionalities in order to make motorcycle riding safer and more comfortable. I mean, for example, something like navigation is today at pace car not thinkable anymore. And this should be also the case for the two-wheelers.
Which would be the biggest evolution from now to 10 years? Because 10 years ago, it was the start of MSC. And now, let's go 10 years forward.
In my opinion, MSC is already a very good base because it's make riding more safer and more robust for all segments. But when I look forward, these three areas we will continue. Reactive systems, ARAS systems, so with the environment, and the connectivity. So we will systematically add more and more functions in these three systems, because once you have the technology and the bike available,
yep,
then you have the possibility to add new functions. And with the connectivity, there is an other space now open. We gain data. So we know what the rider is outside doing. Not the person, but the majority we know. And with this data, we are then capable to think about which function may make sense. The other point is, maybe if you go for riding for 4 weeks in the Alps, you are capable to purchase specific functions for your needs.
Oh, okay.
We call it function and demand.
Function on demand.
Yeah, exactly. If you need, for example, for kilowatt control, in future maybe you can buy it for these 4 weeks because you are on the Alps, you want to have fun, do it. Yeah.
You just buy for a limited time.
Yeah.
Maybe you will do it. Yeah. We cannot talk about future without talking even if electric motorcycles.
Yeah.
What will be you think would be the integration between technology and electric motorcycles?
Let's call it so. Electrification is very similar also on the passenger car. It is very useful when it's come to small light vehicles. Why it is so? Because for me as a person, it's a very easy evaluation. I have three axes: cost, volume or weight, and range. So if you think about different vehicle concepts, then you find out, for example, in the urban mobility, where you don't need that much range, like 100 kilometers already enough, then you find a very good solution for the packaging and it is affordable. So therefore we see, for example, electrification will come more and more over the urbanization vehicles. And that's the reason why we started with the low range of performance between 2 and 6 kilowatts. So that's the reason why I think that electrification will come more and more with the urbanization.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Wilman. Thank you.
Welcome.